Hi, I'm Isabelle MacNeil in Halifax, Nova Scotia. Hurricane season is just winding down here in Atlantic Canada, and we've seen some pretty intense storms this year. Do you ever wonder how experts track storms? There are people working behind the scenes day and night, keeping an eye on the sky. Let's go find out how. We're going into the Atlantic Storm Prediction Center. That's where meteorologists track major storms in Canada, like hurricanes, tornadoes, and blizzards. Hi, I'm Isabelle MacNeil.
Hi, I'm Ian Hubbard. I'm a meteorologist at the Atlantic Storm Prediction Center.
So first things first, what is a meteorologist?
A meteorologist is someone who looks at the sky and studies the weather and forecasts any precipitation or clouds that might come from it.
Say me or someone else wanted to know the weather any time throughout the day, how would we be able to know that it's accurate weather that we'd be getting?
Basically, meteorologists work around the clock. We work 24/7, 7 days a week. We work weekends and holidays as well. So we're always paying attention to the weather, making sure that the latest conditions are being reflected in the forecast and that we're staying on top of things so that if you do need to know what the weather is, you're gonna get the latest forecast at your fingertips.
How do you track all your storms?
Well, we use a variety of tools. Radar would be one that we use for precipitation. We use computer models as well that show us where the low pressure and high pressure systems are going. And we also use satellites, which show us an exact picture of the sky as seen from space.
What? Satellites, radars, and computer models for low and high pressure systems? Let's back up a second, starting with radar.
I can show you something here on the radar, actually. This is the current radar over Nova Scotia, and all of these returns here are showing where it's raining. And depending on the color, it shows you the intensity of the rain. So, for example, out here where it's gray and blue, it would be light rain. As you move closer to these green areas, it's becoming a little bit heavier. And then the strongest rain right now would be these yellow with a little bit of orange in there as well.
What would a tornado look like on one of these?
Well, a tornado would occur in a thunderstorm, so it would be at least orange, if not red. And we actually have a different map that we would look at for that, that shows us properties of the thunderstorm that we'd be able to pick out a tornado if there was one occurring.
So right here we know what radar is. What does low pressure look like?
Well, low pressure refers to an area of the atmosphere. So when we have a low pressure system, we have to look at a weather map, which is what this screen shows. And usually that's designated by an L for low. These are basically what you get for storms. So anytime you see a low pressure system, that means it's a storm. Now depending on how intense it is, you might get different weather from that, whether it's a little bit of rain or an awful lot of rain or snow, and maybe even a lot of wind as well. The only other one we would look at on a map like this would be a high pressure system, which is the opposite of a low. So it's fair weather. There's no storms in there and usually not any precipitation or very little wind as well.
What do you mean when you say fair weather?
Sunny skies, good days.
Good days, that's what you want. So now we know what radar looks like in low pressure. What does satellite look like?
Well, satellite would look like this, basically. This is taking a picture from space from one of the satellites, looks down at the Earth. And what we're seeing here is what you would see if you were in space, let's say on the space station. And so where there's no cloud, you actually get to see the surface of the Earth, whether that's the land or the ocean, and it looks a lot darker. So right here, we're seeing a bunch of clouds move up through here, and a lot of Canada right now has cloud all over it.
So in 10 years, do you think you'll still be working here as a meteorologist because all this technology is helping us know the weather? So do you think we'll still need people?
I think we'll always need people to do the weather. One of the things that a person can do that a computer model can't is talk about local knowledge and things that happen around smaller areas that we know through experience, which a computer model wouldn't be able to do.
Well, thank you for your time and listening to my questions and answering them.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming in.
Thanks.